Accordingly, Gwanetha Callisto Killion of ZANU-PF Party has been duly elected member of the National Assembly for the Chiredzi South constituency.
The Zimbabwe Electoral Commission results showed President Emmerson Mnangagwa's ZANU-PF cruising a big majority after picking up 109 seats in a 210-seat parliament. The opposition Movement for Democratic Change, MDC Party, managed to win only 41 seats with result for 58 seats still to be announced. The ZANU-PF would need to win 30 more to have a two-thirds majority that would allow it to change the constitution at will. Monday's vote was Zimbabwe's first election since long-term President Robert Mugabe was pushed out of office last year. Observers say that the rural vote was key in the election since the majority of people are in rural areas. It will be crucial to see if the opposition parties will accept the results. They allege there has been vote rigging and are threatening to release their own set of results. Some have even threatened to protest.
The results are not correct. As far as I know, the results are not correct. ZANU-PF is taking some results of MDC and put to their party. As I'm speaking, the ZANU-PF says, if you are 60 years old, you must go to retirement. Why then don't go to retirement?
The opposition leader said on Tuesday he was winning resoundly, a claim denied by the Electoral Commission. A presidential runoff will be held on September 8th if a candidate does not secure more than 50% of the vote. More than 5 million Zimbabweans registered to take part in the poll. The Electoral Commission said 1.3% of the registered voters could not cast their vote because they presented the wrong documents at polling stations. 23 candidates, 19 men and 4 women contested for the presidency, all first-time contenders. Previous elections in Zimbabwe have been marred by intimidation and threats, but campaigning this time has been relatively peaceful.
So far the results are okay, but all what we need is jobs. Whether ZANU-PF or MDC wins, but we want jobs.
Ourselves as Zimbabweans, we showed exemplary behavior, and I would like Zimbabweans to continue along that route. The world is watching. Let us show the world that we can run our own country, that we love our country. Let us not resort to violence. We can agree to disagree, and there are routes that can be taken by those who disagree, namely go to the courts if you wish to challenge anything.
Elections observers from the European Union and the United States have also been allowed to monitor the vote for the first time since 2002.